Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Waller's Wallet, and over the last few months, we've seen Chase add temporary grocery benefits to their cards, and it's made me think, if Chase were looking to add a permanent grocery category to one of their cards, which card would it go on? Now, if you want a simple way to help out the channel, consider hitting that thumbs up button. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn that bell notification on as well, so you don't miss out on future videos. Now, I actually asked this question in my YouTube community tab and even in my Facebook group, and the results were a little bit mixed, with people really wanting to see a grocery category added to the Chase Sapphire Reserve or even the Sapphire Preferred. But as I've been thinking about it, I think there are a couple scenarios that could be possible if Chase were looking to add a permanent grocery category, so let's explore those. Now, I do think we're going to see Chase add a permanent grocery category to one of their cards, because I think they see there's a big market for it. And they're seeing people use their cards more frequently because they've offered increased bonus multipliers for groceries. Plus, their competitors offer grocery categories as well. But first, let's cross off what I don't think we're going to see. And even though many of you do want it, I don't think we're going to see Chase add a permanent grocery category to the Chase Sapphire Reserve. And while it would be nice to see this, it just doesn't seem to fit the mold of this type of credit card. This is Chase's premium travel credit card, and if you look at comparable cards such as the Platinum card and Prestige card for comparison, neither one of those cards have a grocery category. Those banks have regulated that to other cards such as the Gold card or the Premier card to complement these premium travel credit cards. So while Chase could add a grocery category to the Chase Sapphire Reserve, it just seems out of place here, and for that reason, I don't think we're going to see a grocery category permanently added to the Sapphire Reserve. And the other card I don't think we would see a permanent grocery category added to is the Chase Freedom card. It again would just be out of place here to see a stable category on a rotating quarterly category credit card, and we don't see this with other rotating category credit cards like Discover, for example. So for that reason, I don't think the Chase Freedom will have that permanent category, although I would love to be wrong here. Now, I do know Chase is offering 5% back on groceries for a year for new applicants on the Chase Freedom card, but I think that offer is just going to be a one-year deal on the Freedom card, and they're doing this to have people apply for this card. Then another option could be Chase could roll out a new credit card, but I don't know if they would just roll out a card just for groceries. Maybe they would call it the Freedom Preferred, I don't know, but I think this one here would be unlikely as well. So that leaves just the Chase Sapphire Preferred and the Chase Freedom Limited, and I think Chase actually could go a few ways here. I think Chase could improve the Chase Freedom Unlimited by adding a grocery category here. They could add a 2 or 3x multiplier for groceries and leave the 1.5 points per dollar everywhere else alone. This would definitely make this card more appealing, and it would give Chase a permanent grocery category and would also complement the more premium Chase credit cards. Or Chase could completely revamp the Chase Sapphire Preferred, which is something I've said they need to do for quite a while now. Because frankly, the Chase Sapphire Reserve is just a card you get for the bonus. But if they were to revamp this, they could take a page from American Express and Citi and make this a more complimentary card to the Reserve, just like American Express does with the Platinum and Gold card, and what Citi does with the Premier and the Prestige card. Now, in order to do this, they would need to remove that one Sapphire card rule for people in order for them to get both of these cards. And that's something they could totally do. They could even leave that 48-month rule for bonuses in place if they wanted to. And if they did this, they could make a great card that really hits on where Chase has been lacking, which includes a grocery category and maybe even a gas category. Now, I think this would need to earn at least 3x on groceries since there still is that annual fee, and it would put it on par with the Premier card if they left that annual fee at $95. But if Chase was feeling froggy and wanted to leap, they could go 4x on groceries and really challenge the American Express Gold card here, but I do think that would come with an annual fee hike as well. And this is something they definitely can do, and I think they should really consider it because the Chase Sapphire Preferred is just not competitive with those credit cards. And another option is adding a grocery category to both the Chase Sapphire Preferred and the Freedom Unlimited. And this one would be a page out of Citi's book with the Premier and the Reward Plus. But I think at this point, people would be just fine if Chase copies someone else. And in this scenario, Chase would give the Freedom Unlimited 2x earning rates on grocery spend since it is the fee-free credit card, but reserve the higher earning rates of 3x or 4x for the Chase Sapphire Preferred. and this would give people an option for a grocery spend, and they would still receive some benefit for grocery spending based on the card they chose. And I actually think this would be a great choice to offer customers, because for people who spend less on groceries, they might be perfectly content with 2x ultimate reward points for the grocery spend. And for the larger spenders, they might want that extra earning rate and be willing to pay that annual fee. And if someone was holding the Chase Sapphire Reserve and redeemed their points to the Chase Travel Portal at 1.5 cents per point, that means that would give them a return of up to 3% for a grocery spend with the Chase Freedom Unlimited, and up to 4.5% or 6% back on grocery spend with the Chase Sapphire Preferred. And that would put these in line for value with cards like the Blue Cash Everyday, the Gold Card, even the Blue Cash Preferred. And in any of these situations, I do think there would be a yearly spending limit on groceries. And frankly, I think that $12,000 yearly limit that they're currently offering on the Chase Freedom or Freedom Unlimited as a bonus would be perfectly fine. Because if they went with a $6,000 limit like the Blue Cash Preferred, I think that would just be too low for families. And that is a problem with the Blue Cash Preferred. Now, Chase has been on fire with their temporary benefits and offering increased opportunities to earn points on grocery spend. And when this is all over, I think it would be really hard for Chase to go back and only offer groceries for one quarter a year on the Chase Freedom card and not offer a more stable and permanent grocery category on one of their cards. And frankly, this has been a glaring hole in Chase's earning rates for a long time now. And hopefully, just hopefully, they see the value in having a grocery category on one of their cards, and it drives them to make a change. So tell me, would you use a Chase card more if it had a permanent grocery category? Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in this video. If you want to help support the channel, take a look at the links down in the description below. And if you know somebody that could benefit from this video, feel free to share it with them. And until next time, it's a travel and take care.